This is Deeside Leisure Centre, home of the Deeside Dragons ice hockey team. After a 23-year championship drought, the Deeside Dragons now stand 3 wins away from the league championship. It's been a long journey back to the top. Few remain from their previous championship team. One of those is Stephen Fellows, defenceman and former head coach. He remembers their last league championship.
23 years ago we won the league, Conference League it was called back in the day, and then obviously we're very close on achieving our goals this year, and that again with the Dragons, something we've not achieved for the last 3 years while we've been established back as the Dragons. For my early memories, and it's quite interesting, Ross Kennedy, Alex Parry, who's the sons of Phil Kennedy and Steve Parry, I played in the team with their dads when we won 23 years ago. So you know, they're the sort of players that inspired me as a young lad when I was playing at the 15, 16, and now I'm sort of I'm the veteran in the team, and they're the sons of the fathers who I played with. You know, we were one of the most successful teams, Dragons teams. You know, so. Yeah, it doesn't come around too often. You know, I'm married, I've got family. This evening, I was knackered from work, so instead of spending quality time with the missus, I went to bed for a couple of hours. I've woke up at 9:30, gone downstairs, said, hey, right, all right, see you later. I'm off to hockey. And, you know, all right, draw. But that's the lifestyle of hockey. You either do it or you don't. There's no in between. You have to, you know, you have to go for it. Like, and that's how it's been for me. And a lot of the lads in there, it's the same. You know, twice a week we get here for 10 o'clock. We train till 12 o'clock, and then we commit at the weekend. Sometimes you're away for the 2 weekends. We're not professionals. We're amateurs, so we all have to work and make a living. So it's getting up in the morning, not feeling great. And just get on with it. But you either do it or you don't. There's no middle ground for me. And I've been doing it since a very young age. And even though I'm in my older, sort of like later years now, I still find it difficult to walk away from it, because it's such, you know, I kind of think, well, what will I do instead? You know, what will replace the thrill that you get from playing hockey? And I don't know, you know.
You referred to before that your brother was involved. Mm-hmm. What's it like being as part of an ice hockey family?
Yeah, it's great. Yeah, I mean, he stopped playing probably 10 or 12 years ago, but it was great for us, but not so good for the parents, especially my mum bringing us down here late at night when we couldn't drive. So sometimes, especially when we were young, it was sort of 3-4 nights a week, late night training. So we thought it was great, but for our parents, it probably wasn't that great. And it's the same for everybody's parent, really, especially when they're younger, down here late at night. It's a lot harder, especially when they've got to get up for work the next day as well.
It probably used to take over when I was younger. And my parents used to bring me Wednesday, Thursday night, 10:30 till midnight. It was one night my mum, one night my dad. And then when I'd start to drive myself, it became a lot easier, I'd imagine. But it's still drive my kit in the living room or whatever, getting sheltered out because I moved this smelly stuff out the way. And I think it always takes over a bit.
Would you have it any other way?
No. I think they probably still miss it because they don't get to come off as often as they once did.
It's difficult having 2 young children, a job as well. But it's the same with, you know, most of the guys on the team now have got young families and they've all got jobs. We're all doing this as a hobby, but the amount of time it takes up and the late nights as well. I think, you know, some weekends having 2 games, you can't really do anything the weekend. It takes up your whole weekend, especially away games. You'll be leaving the house at sort of 10:30 in the morning, not getting back till nearly midnight. So it's, you know, it's a lot of commitment, especially for enjoyment as well. And nobody's getting paid to do it. The lads must enjoy it because of the amount of time and effort they put in, not just on the ice, but off the ice as well.
It's just been a way of life with kids or without kids. So I think even when I've had, when the wife's had kids, it's just still the norm, really. Nothing changes. She'll tell you that. It's just hockey is normal, and then you make it work just so you can play, still carry on playing.
Just work Monday to Friday, basically. Wednesday, Thursday training. Obviously, just trying to balance it really between hockey, work, and you know, I've just got a little girl now, so trying to spend some time with her, trying to make the most of it, watching her grow up.
Training's late nights and everything like that, and work is early in the morning, so it's tough for me. And my girlfriend certainly doesn't like hockey for those reasons as well, because I'm out all the time. But you know, it's hard at times, and there's been times where you know you think, you know, is it worth it now? You know, I'm heading for 30, and you know, you got to start to think if it's worth it for you. But I don't regret doing it. I love doing it. So, and I'm going to carry on for a good few years yet, I think. You know, but I think everybody has those thoughts at times.
Go gym, sleep, repeat.
I just enjoy playing the game, you know, and all the lads down here. Yeah, we get along really well and just have a great laugh down here, so it makes it worthwhile coming down.
Getting off from work at 5, meeting up at 6 to get up to 7. Yeah, so you had an hour at home. And then you got all night here, then you come home at 1:30 in the morning, up at 6 for work. Same again Thursday. Saturday, Sunday. You know, if you've got a game Saturday on the road, you're leaving about 1 o'clock in the afternoon. So it's an all day thing. You're travelling and playing.
So the commitments weekend wise is pretty intense. Yeah,
it's tough. You know, when I was playing EPL, I was in the gym three, four times a week.
Yeah.
I was on the ice 3 times a week, and then I got a game Saturday, Sunday. You know, so it's just all hockey. You know, you're working a bit during the day, gymming Monday, Thursday.
Yeah, I've been playing for 12 years. So.
Oh, that's all right then.
Yeah, but I've had my fair share.
But you'll come back at some point. You will, mate, trust me.
That's what everyone says.
I've got to do some sort of sport, but there's nothing structured. Yeah, I might pop on with the rec sessions. You know, and now it's a few times.
See, you're talking about retiring, and you're already setting yourself up for another team.
But I won't play in a league.
It's in your blood. You can't get rid of it, mate.
Yeah. Just because, like I said, you know, especially January's been a killer. We're 7 games in 4 weeks, so you know, three weekends having 6 games. It's just it's been a lot of games. You know. I don't think our league should play over Christmas.
Well, yeah.
It's a lot, and obviously you want to enjoy yourself as well, so at this level it's like...
But do you not think that you benefit from having those games over Christmas now, as you're coming into the last run of the season?
Well, you've got a bit of a breather. You know, if you look at March, you know, we've got only got 2 games.
No, but you've got a breather going into what could be a possible playoff.
Although, you know, we've got Widnes at home, which could be potentially a title decider,
yeah.
And we're not playing the week before, you know, so...
Would you not get a scratch game in there, though?
I reckon they should. Yeah, you know, I'd rather have a game before that weekend to keep your eye in kind of thing. If you've got a weekend, you're a bit relaxed, you come back and, you know...
I think it can be
a bit harder, really.
It's not pretty good.
Yeah, I think you want to just keep playing. When you've got the momentum, just keep playing.
Yeah.
The Deeside Dragons train on ice at the Leisure Centre between 9 p.m. and midnight, twice a week. It's a huge commitment, especially for sportsmen considered amateur at this level. That being the National Ice Hockey League of Great Britain. Deeside Dragons play in the Laidler Conference, what used to be Northern Division 2.
So we're getting a little piece, maybe a little bit further back there. We're going to deep in the pass, going to go deep to D, take up the ball, get a pass back, give it to that D, pivot again, D to D, hit him with the puck, go down, take a shot. So that corner will be going to that D, and this side will be going to that D.
Okay, so we've got the first line against the second line. 2D on the board, 2D on the board. The idea is to get it to the D, D to D. They take a shot on this goal. The forwards, if they then get the puck there on the opposite team, they play it to their D and again they attack. So there's a goal facing this way, a goal facing that way. So it's a game situation.
Just like trying to get it to the defense quick and get the forward to come left for the rebound. Obviously, like the D-man stay on the board to take a quick shot and the forward to like, react to the rebound. So I can't score it now and then I crash the net and then look for the rebound from the shot. And obviously, the defense has got to move them.
So what's it improving like?
Just basically, improving the D-man shot as well, keeping it nice and low for the forwards. And then, like, the forwards react to the time to get the rebound. Like, into the shot now. And then that's there, and then the pants on the puck, but the D-men have got to react as well, you know, to move it. So it's like a game-like situation, so if the forward's going to get the rebound, and the D-men's got to move him. Be aggressive in front of the net, basically.
Yeah.
It's all it's about. It's not letting the forwards get the better of you.
End of another late night. Why did you hang around in a leisure centre till midnight on a Thursday night? What keeps you coming back?
Because we love hockey! Yeah! Well, to be honest with you, because we're in the position we're in, it just makes us come back and train harder, and it's about seeing the guys as well. And getting better as a team. It's going to be good the next few games. We're just hungry for the win all the time, so that's why we push to try harder. Yeah, I started roller hockey, I'm guessing at 13. Played a couple of seasons and then met a few guys that played ice hockey and then eventually moved up the ladder. I met my dad, Lopal, in the rec team.
If you weren't doing this,
what would I be doing? There's a question. Well, I'd go to the gym anyway, so I'd probably be in the gym. And I don't know. I mean, I did play a bit of five-a-side, but that was a bit of fitness. I couldn't really answer that. I'd probably maybe, if I didn't play ice, I'd probably be still playing roller. But before I was playing actual roller hockey, I was into golf. And that's where I got my big shot from, I think.
So what keeps you the D-side? Have you ever thought about?
I thought about going different places, but it's the lads, the ice. The ice is just the dream to play on, and it's wide. But no, it's the lads that do it for me, because the good mates out of hockey. It's the laugh as well. It's a banter. That's what it's all about, and it's just great.
How do you feel about Nottingham this week?
Well, it's going to be tough. We can't underestimate them. Charles, getting an interview here. Shut up! You can't shoot. Anyway, we can't think that we're going to win the game because we're not. I mean, that's when we mess up and start losing. But we've just got to stay positive, work hard and do what we do best. Oh, it's great. It's great seeing all the fans, the crowd. And it's just nice to get that support. And then when you see people with tops on, with your name on the back, it's just a nice moment.
Well, see, I've got an hour drive home now, so back off half one, up at six, ready for work. You know, but you got to love the game, haven't you? You know, you love being with the guys, you've got a great dressing room, you know, even the young ones. So, hi, Captain.
How you doing?
Running.
Cheers, man. Where do you live, mate?
Shrewsbury.
You drive all the way to Shrewsbury?
Me and Paul.
How long did that take you?
About an hour.
Just in their metal cabins.
Yeah. No, that's where we stay till tomorrow night. Bed and breakfast. We're going to double blow mattress and one pillow between us.
Game day, and Deeside Dragons face the Nottingham Lions tonight. With less than 2 hours before face-off, Captain Mark Lovell and netminder Matt Compton prepare for an off-ice warm.
Welcome to the den. We're in town, baby. All right, the boys.
You're looking forward to the game today, lads?
Yeah, can't wait. Hey, Stevie. Stevie's sitting down yet again. It's all he does, bad knees. Where's Jack?
Not here.
Oh, can't see
all
the video.
Going forward to the game today, Steve?
Yeah, can't wait. Should be a good one.
Big game, the end of the season.
Witness what you mean. That one, that's the big game right at the end of the season.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Are you playing tonight?
I am playing tonight, yeah.
You were doing your warm-up?
Just done my warm-up, ready to rock and roll.
Stevie needs to get here and warm their knees up, that's all I'm saying. To be honest, if I'm completely honest with you, warming up downstairs with my warm-up. Just 5 minutes today, then go back to the rink and get cold. I think it'll be a tough game. They always bring a young side, but they'll skate all night long, so you never know. And we have to be careful, because they're the only team that beat us this season, so we can't take anything too lightly.
Get in the ball pit. Yeah. I'm off for the ball pit.
I'm off for the ball pit.
The pre-game warm-up.
You have to crawl through here.
Kenny's man as well, finger on his way back down.
And a hat.
Yeah.
He's got a gold finger to see warm-up.
I've got one already. He gave me a gold finger, probably.
What was it like scoring, Ken?
Pure luck. Closed my eyes and hit the puck and it went in.
Big stuff on Twitter.
Was it?
Shouty capitals.
There you go. There you go, pal. You don't get that many to go there.
You couldn't do it every week, pal, could they?
You get bored of the shower if I like score, don't
I? Shut up! Wow.
Yay!
Dragon.
Yeah,
alright, man. He just won the challenge because Kenny scored like for us, you know.
So. I'm a little mad. I can't deny it.
It was quite mad.
You know, we've got a bit of a thing going on.
Me and Kenny got a competition.
Yeah.
He's in the lead just by a little bit, bro.
Yeah.
Ain't nothing.
Everything's fine.
I'm gonna score a hat trick and everything. Even it up.
Quite a thing.
Do you think the hat's bringing you luck?
Yep. I'm going to take the hat with the ice cream. They still have their blankets, as well, I've seen.
Yeah, we need to
take one of them, isn't it? Keep one in the telly box just
the
in
hats,
case.
The foam fingers, we're all over it tonight.
been coming about 5 years. I'm fairly local, even though I'm a witness boy. But Deeside's a club now.
My lad plays for the junior side, under 15s at the moment. He joined when he was 10, but he's only 13 now, but it's our fourth season here, yeah.
And what's it like coming down to Deeside for a game?
Brilliant. Atmosphere's great, crowd's great, team's awesome. I mean, there's a bit of banter with the fans, and it's a good laugh, cracking laugh.
Coach in the changing room, see what Lowell's got to say. Yeah, probably tell us the Lions, who's starting, game plan, all that stuff. Let me just get changed, ready for warm-up at 6:30 usually.
My son's been playing for Deeside since he was 6 years of age. Mark Lovell.
And how long have you been coming down here to watch them play?
Oh, since he played junior ice hockey, and I've watched him to develop into the senior team.
And the other generation of the local family, your dad's quite notorious in the crowd. What's that like hearing your dad having a pop?
I'm just used to it now. I know what he's like. So I found it funny when he first started, so I just take it with a pinch of salt now. I still find it funny now.
And what is it about ice hockey?
Oh, it's so rough and banter, the friendliness after. You don't get that in other sports, other than rugby.
And what about the engagement of yourself and the players during the game?
Oh, I love it, love it. Try to get involved with the referees, tell them their decisions, where they go wrong. We call them the three blind mice.
And how do you think the season's gone for Deeside this year?
Oh, absolutely fantastic. Going back to the old days.
John Seymour.
Hey,
boys.
Hey,
look
hey.
At this.
Yeah. Look at this. Here we go. Yeah, man. They're my boys.
Well, for today's game, boys.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Woo!
That's how we roll. Line two.
Okay, why Deeside?
Why Deeside? Because I work here. It's great to see all the football kids coming to support the ice hockey today as well, Deeside Dragons Football Club. Fantastic turnout, the crowd today is brilliant, so yeah, brilliant day all had by all.
And how long have you been coming here?
It's been about 5 years now, I think, altogether. Started off with a away game in Scotland on the Ale, and it's gone on from there, really.
Do you think the change in ownership over the past couple of weeks is going to improve the Dragons for the next couple of
days? I think so. I think the red hockey thing was an exciting thing to happen. For one reason or another, it hasn't worked out. But now we've got Pete involved, and obviously Flixer have taken back control part time for now as well. I think it's looking tonight. It's fantastic.
How long have you been coming down to Deeside?
About 5 years.
And why Deeside?
Because they were the only one with an ice rink that was close to where I live.
And why choose ice hockey as a sport to come and see?
It's fast paced. Loads of goals and cheaper than football.
Always love game day.
What is it about game day that's special?
Look around, the lads, the hockey.
Bobby, you got to put it on.
Put it on.
Put it on.
How's this?
Look at him.
Mike. I look like you, mate.
How many points you got?
Yeah! Oh, nice get out on camera, don't you?
Yeah. Yeah. Answer it.
Just
answer the camera. Come on, pal.
Don't have 50 goals, mate, coach.
Every game you play,
is
a final now. Three finals. And we're the league champions.
I don't need to do team talk now because I'd only be saying the same things I've said all season. And we know our systems, we know our breakouts, we know our trap, we know what we have to do in their zone, we know what we have to do in our zone, we know what we have to do in the neutral zone. So we just reiterate the fact every training session. It's all about getting the guys up for it. You know, they're laughing and joking now in about 10 minutes' time, 20 minutes' time when you come off the warm up. We'll be in professional mode.
With six games remaining in the Deeside Dragons fixtures, they're going to continue to push for that league title here tonight, but they can't afford to take their foot off the gas against the only team who's put a blip on that near-perfect record and that's the Nottingham Lions.
If they're sitting at the top of the table, everybody below them is looking to be that one team that knocks them off, and Nottingham being the only team they have so far, they're quite proud of that. But what you've got to remember is you've got quite a strong side inside. You've got some really key players, and the one thing that all the teams seem to do when they come here is struggle to stop the key players like your Parlacs and your Supers.
Listen, boys, three cup finals, that's what's in our way now. Get these out the way tonight. Get all out the way and get Widnes out the way, and it's our league. But let's take tonight's game. We've got to dictate the pace tonight. If we start games, guys, if we start quick, we blow everyone away. If we drop to their level, we start to struggle. It's all about getting the first goal. Once we get the first goal, we're on our way. But it's all about getting that first goal tonight. Well, listen, boys, this is our f***ing barn. This is the only team to beat us here this season. So we all have a bit of revenge. But we're a much improved team. That was a blip, and we learned a lesson from that. We haven't been beaten since the 3rd of October last year. But the confidence levels are high. I think we've got a fantastic squad here, boys. Our barn, let's do the business, OK?
Let's go.
Mustache's last game, man. The mustache's looking good, man. It's the last game.
Game for
last
the
game for the Tash. Let's go out with a bump and start.
Huge game tonight against one of their top opponents, and a huge crowd here tonight as well. Fellows behind his net looking for somebody up front. Miscue there by Roberts, loses the puck. Fellows had to go back for it. Fellows and Jones, line mates for tonight. Jones dumps it in. It's picked up by Alan Roberts. Davis on the blue line, tries to play it out front, tried to get it to Chappell, but it was knocked out of the zone as Roberts has to play it in again. Along the boards, held up. And you can see the coaching staff there at Nottingham shouting their orders from the bench, certainly vocal.
They're coming here with their A game tonight. You can tell by the way that they're attacking, Dave, that they mean business.
That's certainly true, that Gary. Nottingham are fired up for this game. As Lovell forced back into his own zone. Played in. Deeks shot. Well, the net, Nottingham netminder, 31, Thomas Howell, was just strong in net. Held his ground. Halleck brought into the boards, and it's, as we suspected, a bit of physical play there with Halleck.
It's like we said at the beginning, Dave, every team's coming here to try and shut him down.
Tied up in the skates of Halleck, who turns it round, he skates it in, shot through the legs at the rebound, the crowd was on their feet. Best opportunity of the night so far. But Nottingham turn it around the other way and score the opening goal. And that's number four, Connor Glossop. The Dragons going to have to play smart defensively tonight, I think. And it's another goal. Proof that the Nottingham Lions' plan of attack is sound. And Connor Glossop racks up another one. So the Nottingham Lions go on the attack on the power play. Bryn Roberts is sitting out for a cross check. And a hook there on Halleck. As he shoots and it's in, it's a goal! Shorthanded for the Deeside Dragons!
Oh boy! Okay, we've started now, guys!
Oh, it's a panic, baby!
short-handed goal for Adrian Palak. Has taken the wind out of the power play cells, and he's going at it again! Round the back, and he's held up, and the referee's going to call that.
It's a penalty, isn't it?
Yeah.
A penalty is a penalty, isn't it?
Yeah, penalty's
so
a penalty.
So what? So when the diver comes to it, that's in the rule now, is it?
Yeah.
How can you get a penalty and a dive at the same time?
So we've got coincidental minors charged to Ads Andrews, who goes down for a hook. And we've got Adrian Palak, who's got 2 minutes for diving.
So it's a bit of a Didier Drogba there then.
Shot, and it's a goal! Dragons fire back, Simon Fairbairn. Every time a penalty's called, the Dragons.
You're not
fucking winding up as well.
Listen,
up to me. Go,
let's not mention it again. Let's not mention it again. Just let's go. Let's get this 10-8 minutes out the way. Hey, great club check there, mate. Great work on the boards. I know you did. That's not like you, mate. That's not like you. Well, forget about it now. Forget about it. Do between the legs. Not like you.
Listen, guys. Great comeback, guys. Let's get the positives. Great comeback. Two short-handed goals as well. Way to go. Listen, guys. When I started to play hockey, used to hear this saying all the time: soft hands, soft hands. If you're a little bit nervous and you're rigid, the puck's going to hit your stick and bounce off. And we were all a little bit nervous there. All a little bit. You could see a little bit of tension, and it's going to be tense. These are the only team that beat us, and they're going to escape at us. But we're a well better side. We've got a well better side, boys. We're not physical enough, guys. We're not physical enough. And when we are physical, we're getting 2 minutes. The referee's not going to give you nothing. But the worst of all, Bryn, is what we talk about every game. Stupid penalties. I've never seen a referee change his mind in his life. He calls a penalty, it's no good even speaking to him. Just blank him. Because he's not going to change his mind. So don't go arguing with him, you're just wasting your breath. George has held his hands up. First one was a little silly mistake. George has had a fantastic season. Kept us in massively in games. That's forgotten about. I've had a word with Bryn, it's forgotten about. 0-0 period, let's get out there and make me f***ing proud. Like you do every week.
Chapel fanned on that shot. Shot from Palak. Chapel tries to get it out of that corner. Cross ice to some space to Bryn Roberts. Takes a shot. Chipping away at it. Palak gets it in. Palak second of the night. Put the puck on the net and good things will happen, and that's exactly what we've just seen. Matt Wainwright manages to get it out front and it's cleared. Lovell's going to skate that in. Tries to turn it round. Gets it out front, but it's stopped by Joseph Gretton. Gavin Austin's forced back for that. Parsons gets it up front. As we enter the last minute of the second period. And it's been a quiet middle act, this, Gary.
Very much so. It's gone really, really quickly as well.
Shot and it's in! Simon Furnival extends the Dragons' lead to 2 late in the second period.
Good time to get it just as they're going in.
Awesome. Absolutely awesome.
What a time to
play. Simon Furnival, massive goal.
Massive goal. 35 seconds before the end of the period. Ooh. Listen, boys, way to come back from 2-0 down. Shows character that. You know what we did there? We showed them too much respect in the first period, and then we showed them no respect. Larry, smack. That kind of gloss has done nothing since you've done it, mate. Nothing. Otherwise, go, boys, listen, there's nothing to say. Let's stick to the game plan. I'm going to leave the lines as they are for a bit. I'll try my best to get back to running four lines. But otherwise, boys, tune up early. Well done, guys. Let's go.
And so the Dragons get through. Palak takes a shot, gets a rebound. It's in. It's a goal for Adrian Palak. His third of the night.
Guy's on fire tonight.
And he's going to start the third period with a big hat-trick. And that's exactly the kind of start to the third period that the Dragons needed. And now Lions fighting back the other way. Humphreys and Glossop shot into the chest of the netminder. It's loose out front. Humphreys has got it, turns it round, shoots. And again, beats the goaltender. Top shelf. And Joe Humphreys puts the Nottingham Lions back on the board for the first time since the first period. It's 5-3.
Some power in those shots there, Dave, and it'd be difficult for any keeper to stop. But it was coming, wasn't it? The Lions weren't giving up.
Well, let's not forget there were two goals in quick succession for Nottingham early in the first period. There's still plenty of time for them to get back into this game. And they do! There we go! Second goal of the third period for the Nottingham Lions, and that's courtesy of number 8, Joe Humphreys. Palak knocked down by Ads Andrews. And I imagine that was quite satisfying for Andrews to take down Palak.
Well, tempers are flaring up a little now, Dave, so I can see a few penalties.
Slashing penalty assist to Bryn Roberts. Both teams 4-on-4. But again, the Dragons, whilst killing off a penalty, managed to score another goal, and that one's going to be courtesy of Mark Lovell. If there's ever a chance to take control of this game again, it's now. As the first penalty to Deeside expires, Nottingham get the puck in the back of the net. And Cameron Powell. And now there's a fight breaking up from the bench. Matty Compton grabbed Joe Humphreys. Super sends it cross ice. Wainwright keeps it in at the point. Parsons brings it out front, and it's a goal. Simon Furnival gets another one in.
Obviously Furnival got himself a hat-trick tonight, but one man ran that whole show tonight, and that was Palak. And you know, there's no doubt that is a top player. He earns his money and he's doing his job. My guys are still paying £90 a month to play, and we're enjoying our hockey.
Development League's fine, and if you want that mentality, you're not a winner. You're developing kids in your development league. Leave them there. If we want to escape and we want to get promotion into the first division and we want to go further and win the first division, then we've got to think outside the box. We're not a development team here. We're the senior team at Teesside, and we're not developing. We're developing players so they can play at a higher standard. We're not developing players so they can stay at the same standard.
I was a little bit disappointed with Nottingham.
you know, probably not going to play them again for a while. And I was disappointed with their coaches' tactics, trying to get our lads kicked out the game, obviously because we've got home next week with the Witness game coming up. That was obviously a tactic, but I'd like to commend our guys for not getting suckered into something like that. What I am disappointed in as well is a game of that magnitude, and the EIHA sent two officials, and one of them's a pensioner as well, about 65, 70, who can't see that well. So it's disappointing that a game of that magnitude, he'd send two officials who lost control of the game in the first period. But what I will say, guys, is thanks very much for your effort. I apologise if not everyone got on tonight. It didn't go to the script, but I'm proud of you all, because 2 points is 2 points. Let's get the music on, guys.
Next time on Dragons Fire.
And you ask anyone in our league, you want to get out, you want a better team, and you want to get out of this league, they'd say yeah to you.
Nick Lancy, how are you doing? Hockey night tonight!
He had 10 this morning and then 2 dropped out.
Out front shot, and it's in, it's a goal for the Hull Jets!
What a goal.
Down the other way is Beach again, he's out front shot, and it's in! It's a goal for Kieran Beach!
League title on the line here, boys, and we're playing against 8 men. So everyone in this room, dig deep and give whatever you've got, whether we're going against 8 men or 18 men.